Hello, welcome to the first chapter of the Banker's Masterclass series on Building Back Better in association with Lloyds Bank. I'm Joy Macknight, editor of The Banker, and with me is Scott Barton, head of corporate and institutional at Lloyds Bank. Thanks for joining me, Scott.
Hi, Joy.
The past 18 months has been truly extraordinary, driven by the global pandemic. What are some of the bigger challenges your customers faced, and how have you really approached them?
Well, Joy, I think you're absolutely right. It's been an incredible time, and probably the sort of worst global economic crisis since I read the Great Depression. It's been the UK. It's been a sort of trinity of the pandemic, Brexit, and also the ramping up of plans towards transition to net zero by 2050. Clearly, that presents a lot of challenges, but I also want to underscore lots of opportunities for our clients as well. Now, our focus at Lloyds Bank has been very much on helping businesses recover from the pandemic, helping them build back stronger, particularly around infrastructure, but also to build back greener. And I'm sure we'll touch on that later. Now, one of the earliest challenges for the banking sector and for Lloyds was to make sure at the outset of the pandemic that we were mobilising rapidly to support the liquidity needs of our clients. And it's been quite a tremendous effort across the industry. We provided over £13 billion of support to more than 330,000 businesses across the government, various government schemes. In addition to that, £31 billion of gross lending to small and medium-sized businesses, which included the government-backed lending as well. One other key area of focus for us that's been at the forefront of our minds is the rapidly changing landscape across payments. These trends have been going for a while, but I think they've proven more in focus during the pandemic, and some of them have actually accelerated as well. Just by example, during the pandemic, the use of cash fell by 35%, and in the UK, 65% of adults use mobile apps for digital commerce. Now, as part of our strategic investment program, which we actually announced at Cybos in 2018, we've built out a real step change in our cash management and payments capabilities, and that's been under the umbrella of Lloyds Bank Gem platform. Now, this represents a major step up in our capabilities. The platform has been developed and fully landed this year, and it allows us to meet much better the complex needs of our customers. Now, what are some of the aspects and capabilities here? Firstly, it's about an omni-channel experience. We've got comprehensive self-serve functionality, and also 24/7 access. It is also fully in tune with ISO 20022 and fully SWIFT GPI compliant. It also provides a wealth of data analytics capabilities powered by cloud computing to provide superb insight for businesses.
And then what were the outward challenges as UK businesses reacted to the mass disruption of global supply chains and then dealt with the final departure of the UK from the EU?
The disruption to supply chains in the UK and globally has been significant post-COVID, and I suspect it will persist for some time. Recent studies suggest that up to 85% of the global supply chain have experienced at least one disruption in the last 12 months. That also coupled with the fact that global trade has decreased by just under 9% in 2020, and shipping costs have actually trebled in 2020. And even for some of the more popular ocean freight routes, there's been a fivefold increase in the last year. Now, I think all of this with a difficult macro backdrop points to the need for resilience. And it's clear that we can do that by creating visibility across company supply chains so we can pinpoint where the key issues are and look to assist. Now, from a supply chain finance perspective, I think it's key in this environment that we remain focused on it, both in terms of the challenges and the opportunities. Ways in which Lloyds is doing that, well, firstly, investment and effective tech partnerships through something, one example, our open account platform partnership with Demica. We're also helping clients go through their ESG requirements via our international trade portal, looking at new markets, new suppliers, and also addressing the challenge of tariffs post-Brexit. We've also adopted a tiered supplier finance program where suppliers are ESG rated. We can tier the pricing depending on suppliers' ESG scores.
And then as the focus turns to the recovery, and as you say, building back better and greener, and as we run up to COP26, which is going to be held in Glasgow at the end of October, beginning of November, how might these present an opportunity that aids the UK's transition to a green economy? And then again, what role do you see for Lloyds Bank in that journey?
We are hugely focused on supporting our customers and indeed the country as part of the transition to net zero by 2050. Enormous challenges, but also, as I mentioned, some opportunities in there as well. How are we doing that? Well, it's a collection of activities. Let me start firstly by talking about the deployment and direction of capital investment that we make. In 2020, we announced an ambition to reduce the financed emissions as a bank by 50% by 2030. We've also seen something like an eightfold increase in sustainability-linked financing requirements from our clients. And that's not only across the traditional sort of high carbon intensity industries, such as energy, transport, and buildings. We've set up a dedicated financing and solutions team, an ESG team, which is a mix of existing and new people to the industry. And also we're really focused on something like the built environment in terms of footprint reduction. Interesting that 40% of total carbon emissions are going to come from buildings. Now, studies suggest to us, focusing on the building and housing sector, that for every pound invested in terms of retrofit, there's a £3 benefit for energy consumption. And indeed, retrofitting millions of buildings and homes over the next 10, 20 years could create something like 500,000 jobs. And if managed correctly, could contribute towards that regional acceleration. It's not just buildings, but also housing as well. And social housing is a big area of focus for us. And I'm delighted to say that sort of over the last 12 months, 90% of ESG-linked bond issuance we have supported at Lloyds Bank in terms of that social housing sector.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for your insights, Scott. In Chapter 2, we'll be looking at payment modernization.